Praise the Lord, everyone. I pray that you're having a blessed day in the Lord today. Today's the day that the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Praise God. Thankful for another day, another opportunity to serve Him, to share what's on my heart. Just on my way to work, and I want to share just a quick thought. Praise God. I know I always say that, and the video ends up being 20 minutes, but this time, I promise it'll be a quick thought. Or at least I think. So I want to share on my heart today about how the storm, we have storms in this life, and how we have the storms of life. And the Word of God teaches us that it rains on the just and the unjust. And sometimes in life things just happen. And a lot of times we're quick to say that it was the enemy. You know, it was Satan. And a lot of times We get in our flesh sometimes, you know. We think, why are we going through this, or why are we facing this? And I begin to think about how we can suffer for well-doing, or we can suffer for wrongdoing. We reap what we sow, and we reap to the flesh, and we reap to the spirit. And the Word of God teaches those things, and I just begin to think about many different things and many different storms and seasons of life, and I begin to think about all those things. But I begin to think about how when Jesus was out on the water, out on the water with the disciples, I begin to think about the storm was great, and I begin to think about how it was lightning, and the billows begin to roll, and it was begin to lightning, and the storm was great, and he was on the boat with them. And Jesus, they went and woke him up, and they said, "Master, we perish." And he got up, and he said, "O ye of little faith," and he rebuked the winds, and he said, "Peace, be still." And they said, they were astonished, and they said, "What manner of man is this, that even the winds and waves obey him?" And I begin to think about how he can do that spiritually. You know, we can go through a storm, but he is our anchor through that storm, and he... if we look to him, he is the eye of the storm. In the eye of the storm, it's calm. And I begin to think about how he speaks to us through the storms of life for whatever reason we're going through them. And his mercy is everlasting. He's, praise God, faithful unto 1,000 generations. And I begin to think about how he can say, "Peace, be still," in our life in the midst of the storm. And I begin to think about, praise God, how the disciples, Jesus came to walk out on the water, and I begin to think about how he is in control of all things. He is the Lord and creator of all. He is the living God, and he made the heavens and the earth. He made the storms and the winds and the lightning, and he made all things, praise God. Colossians teaches us that, you know, through his purpose, and all things were created by him and for him. And I begin to think about how, you know, he is the master of the wind, praise God. When he speaks, the winds and waves obey. They cease at his command. You know, I begin to think about, why do we fear? Why should we worry? Why do we fear, praise God? We don't have to fear the storm, glory be to God, because he is the master of the wind. And I begin to think about when the disciples, he began to walk out on the water, and how he has control over all things, and he began to walk on the water. He didn't sink, he didn't fear, you know, he is the Almighty. You know, the waves are and the winds obey him. Everything is subject to him, because he is the Lord, the creator, the maker, the master. You know, he even told the waves to go this high, and don't you go no further. The sun shines every day, and we can look up and see that sun, and we can see those clouds that are in the sky right now, that hang by his glory, that hang by his word. And Hebrews chapter 1 teaches us that all things are held by the power of his word. Come on, somebody. I feel the power of God. I feel the Holy Spirit in this vehicle right now. Hallelujah. All things are held by the power of his word, praise God. You know, and we can look at the stars and the sun and the clouds, and we can see, praise God, even creation cries out that he's the Almighty, he's the Lord. His word is forever settled in heaven. He is the Almighty. He can walk into every season of our life, every storm of our life, praise God. And I'm telling you, when it's our time to go, nothing can hold us here. Like the song said, nothing can hold me here. Hallelujah. You know, and whenever it's in God's timing to move in our lives and in the storms of our lives, praise God, you know, nothing can stop it when it's the timing of God. You know, for us to be, when He comes back for His children, you know, nothing's going to stop it. It's like labor pains. You know, the earth is groaning for the manifestations of the sons of God, and it's like labor pains. The Lord said that it'll be like a woman in travail in the book of Luke. Hallelujah. How many see the church travailing? How many see earthquakes and tornadoes and signs and wonders and fearful sights and commotions? And we see the signs of the times, of the end time. Come on, somebody. And we see that we're having a press in the spirit, and the enemy's trying to test us at every hand. Glory be to God. And we see those labor pains, and we see the storms of life are coming. But so is the anointing of God. And He said there in the book of 1 John, and He said, it talked about the Antichrist spirits and how there's many and they're upon the earth. But He said, fear not. He said, I've given you the unction. I've given you the Holy Spirit. I've given you the anointing. How many know the anointing breaks the yokes? The anointing drives back hell every time. Hallelujah. The Spirit of God is still strong. It's still mighty. The blood never loses its power. He's still the Almighty. His word still stands as a sure foundation. Praise God. And I just want to encourage you today. People looking at me in these vehicles like I'm crazy. Praise God. I'm just going to keep right on. Praise God. Just want to share this thought on my way to work. So I begin to think about the storms of life, but He's pouring down His anointing, and through each storm we're getting stronger. Hallelujah. He's birthing more character in us, more love in us. He's taking the flaws out. We're learning to trust Him. 'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take Him at His word. Come on, somebody. His promises are yes and amen, and we got to believe them and stand on them. His promises keep us safe from the storms of life. I begin to think about what keeps us safe from the storm, and He is our shelter, our strength, and our high tower. You know, when I begin to think about how Jesus walked out on that water, and Peter said, Master, bid me to come unto thee. And Jesus said, come. And Peter went. But the moment he took his eyes off Jesus, he began to sink. He began to look at the lightning. He began to look at the storm and began to look around him. And he began to sink. But we cannot get our eyes off Jesus in this hour. We can't look at the storm, the doctor's report, the situation. We can't be moved by the voices. How many know there's many voices in the land? But there's only one voice that makes the difference, and that's the voice of the Almighty. And He said, my sheep know my voice, and a stranger's they will not follow. I'm here to tell you, He's the master of the wind. Praise God. I'm here to tell you today, He is the Almighty. He is the living God, and I praise Him. And I want to tell you that He is your anchor. He alone is the anchor. He guards your soul. He is the anchor. He is, praise God, your refuge, praise God, in the eye of the storm, in the middle of a war. How many know there's a war going on? But He is faithful and true. God bless you all.